Hi there, folks, and welcome back. Right, just got back from my morning walk, as usual, for the cholesterol. Oh dear. Oh, the joys of getting older, eh? The joys of getting older. Right, as you can see, the title of today's video is Brotherhood and Remembrance Patches. Now, this is something I've been dealing with, actually, over the last few months with a club. And to get it to come into my inbox as well. Yeah, okay, so I'll touch on it. I don't think anybody else has ever touched on this topic. I know I haven't. I've never touched on it in live streams or anything, but yeah, this deserves an explanation, I think. Now then, Brotherhood and Remembrance Patches worn by two different clubs. This is the gist that I'm getting from this, that would two separate clubs, would it be okay for two separate clubs to fly a remembrance patch to remember a person that was in one of the clubs that was considered very, you know, high regard by both clubs? Would that be an acceptable thing to do? Absolutely. I have seen it. I've seen brotherhood patches in respects of two clubs being very, very close and both of them adopting a patch that they both wear on their waistcoats. I've actually seen that. In fact, I wouldn't say it's a common thing, but it's not extremely uncommon. It is something that happens, and I've seen it. I've actually seen it. And I actually know clubs, a club, where they do wear a patch as a brotherhood patch between themselves and another club. I've seen that. So it's not something that isn't done. Brotherhood patches, remembrance patches. Now, remembrance patches worn by two different clubs. And the gist that I'm getting from this is that two different clubs, a remembrance patch that's worn by both of the clubs for a person that was in one of the clubs. It's a bit of a technical tongue twist, really, when you think about it. But yeah, it can happen. It can happen. It's something that is it's a mark of respect, really, for somebody that was in, you know, regarded in very high regard by both clubs. So it's not something that is not done. It can be done, and it is done. It's not something that's very common. But yeah, it's definitely done. I've seen it done. And I know of it being done. Now, the way I've seen it before in the past is that they both wear a patch that's the same, but not the same, if you know what I mean. So that one club will have it in their colours, but they'll have a colour from the other club included in that patch. And the other club will have the patch done in their colours, but they'll have a colour from the other club included. This one's a tongue twisty one, will be included in their patch. So I have seen that. That's like a bond. This even could considered like a brother patch, I suppose, if you look at it that way. You know, it's a bond between the two clubs. It's some, they thought very highly of one person, that both clubs would wear that one patch, but done in their own colours with a touch of colour from the other club. So it's not a very common thing, but it is done. I've seen it done. And if it's done, you know, from an MC, maybe down to a, you know, a riding club or an MCC, it's not a signal that that MC is like trying to rule over them or anything. It's just it's a mark of mutual respect for a person that both clubs held in very, very high regard. So if that's the gist of the question that was sent to me, well then, yeah, that's perfectly okay. That's perfectly okay. It's a mutual understanding between both of those clubs. And it's a mark of respect when it's done that way. And as I say, brotherhood patches, you know, is something I've seen. I've seen it on a few occasions where, you know, both clubs wear a patch that signifies a bond between those two clubs. I've seen it. It's not something that isn't done. It is something that's done, but it's not a common thing. And is it all right? Well, of course it's all right. If both of the clubs are in agreement on it, then perfectly all right. So I hope that one touches on it. If there's any more of that gist to that, if I've missed something there, the person that sent me in that question, if I've missed something there or missed the point on what you sent, and as I say, I've already been dealing with something like this with another club. So, if that's the gist that you're talking about, can you both have a patch that remembers a particular person that you both held in high regards? Absolutely. And does it mean one club is telling the other club that it's a type of ownership stamp? Absolutely not. Usually when that happens, because it's uncommon, it's not a common thing, but usually when that happens, it means that when those two clubs are sitting at the table together, maybe, that they sit there like, you know, as equals. You know, as equals. It's, it's an awkward one, but it's not something that is never done. It is done, but it's usually the clubs are very, very tight when they do that. They've got a very tight friendship and bond when that happens. But if I've got the gist of that wrong, let me know in a comment, and you know, I'll touch on it. Maybe we could do it in a live stream or something. But as far as that goes, no, that's all cool. As far as I'm concerned, you know, I would never have an issue if I was friends tight with a club having a brother bond patch for a lost brother or something like that. I'd never have a problem with that. And if I was in a club that was tight with another club, I wouldn't have a problem wearing a brotherhood patch either. So, I think I've touched on the topic that you were talking about. But if not, like I say, drop it down in the comments, and you know, it's something maybe we could talk about in live stream. Anyway, you all stay safe, and I will catch you another day, another way. And those that are following my Bikers Explore videos, thank you for following those ones. Yeah. Oh, it's a bit cold. I'm going inside to get warm now. Anyway, you all stay safe. I'll catch you another day, another way. Peace out.